Oak Park has always had a tradition of stained glass. And more important, the residents of Oak Park have always appreciated architectural artifacts and detailing and so on and so forth. So I was one of two studios in Oak Park. Since that time, there have been at least three others that have opened. And they've all gone. I'm the last surviving stained glass artist in Oak Park. Stained glass is cyclical, runs on about a 100-year cycle in popularity. And I regret to say that the popularity is declining now, apparently. It's just a known cycle. My understanding of the history of stained glass shows that it is cyclical. It runs about 100 years in popularity and decline, and then popularity and decline.
How many 100 years does that analysis go back?
At least 1,000, I would say. Yeah. Yeah, it goes back to the Middle Ages.
Wow.
The bevel, that's a wide bevel. Typically, one would find a half-inch bevel. This is probably more like 7/8 of an inch, maybe even a full-inch wide bevel on very thick glass. And that determines both the width and of the bevel and the thickness of the glass determine the refractive character of bevels. And this is highly refractive. And it's in good shape considering the age of this window. You can see the characteristic texture of that hand-blown glass, real smooth and then real heavily pitted. And that's just the quality that really I find attractive. Jewels are thick jewels too. That's another aspect that one doesn't find in more contemporary material. When we build a restoration, the metal that comes out of the box is just bright, shiny gray, and it looks tacky, it looks new. So we always take great pains to try to get a nice patina on the metal, try to make it look old before you come pick it up, and it'll continue to develop that patina for its lifetime. It gets very dark, almost jet black, but very lustrous too. You can always see an old patina. And again, the coloring, this color especially, is sort of
the blue.
Yeah, it's a little less characteristic of the vintage of this window.
Tell me about the pane that you replaced. Was which one?
We replaced this one, trying to match the color of that piece. That was a textured piece of glass that the manufacturer had already supplied that texture. That's a hammer texture is the name. What we had to do was to just give it a very light tint of amber, which we can do in the kiln with a silver stain. We go through the same process for any restoration. The window is taken out of the sash and a rubbing is made. A piece of paper is stretched over it. We use crayons just to make a rubbing that gives us the pattern with which we'll rebuild the window. After the rubbing is made, we will dismantle the window, taking apart the glass very carefully. Sometimes the shapes of these pieces have them locked in. Yours was made of lead came, which we can cut with what we call a nipper, just a diagonal pliers. Cut it apart, then we clean all the glass. In your case, the cracked pieces, since they were irreplaceable, even if we could have found identical matching pieces, we would have used those. In your case, we opted to repair the cracks with copper foil technique, which is reversible. If anyone ever devises a way to bond those pieces back together, that copper foil can be stripped off and it can be made right. Copper foil was invented, I believe, by the Tiffany Studios. And one often sees it on lampshades. Tiffany, so-called Tiffany shades were characteristically done with copper foil technique. A thin tape of copper foil, very thin, 1 mil thick, is applied, wrapped around the edge of all the pieces of glass. And then they can be soldered together. Solder will only adhere to the copper foil itself. It won't adhere to the glass. So one can build up a bead of solder, which bonds the pieces together. And as I say, it's reversible. Since the real active ingredient is the adhesive of the foil, those pieces can be separated again. And it's a process that's not typically used for leaded glass because it can't be made weather tight. After the pieces are cleaned, we lay them out on the pattern we made, that rubbing we made, and rebuild it with metal that's identical to the material that we removed. Then every joint is soldered with 60% tin, 40% lead solder. Then the window is cemented. This is a glazing compound we thin out with paint thinner, brush it into the window. This cement flows under all the lead into the voids in the channel. It'll firm up over 4 or 5 days. Then the excess is cleaned away and the window's polished and glazed back into the sash.
Where's the copper foil?
Copper foil are all of these repairs. Had we been able to glue those pieces and get satisfactory results, that's an occasional remedy too. But with this type of glass, and as shattered as they were, I just thought it was better to just acknowledge the crack and, you know, go with the vintage look of it. Everybody loves red jewels, and a little red goes a long way. So the designer of this window knew that doesn't take much to spark up all of the adjacent colors. The ambers are reminiscent of American coloring. Those jewels, those sort of turquoise jewels, that's atypical. That throws me a little bit. Don't usually see that. That's a more contemporary color, seems to me. Though I'm certain they're all of the vintage era, but whoever colored that window just had a vision that was different from his contemporaries, it seems. I wish I were better informed on stylistic characteristics. That could as easily have been, it seems to me, could as easily have been a European window as an American window. You know, it just, American windows, when I see them, those that are characteristically American, they're plainly evident to me. This one was, I don't know what the motivation of the design was. And the colors are not characteristic of American windows either, especially those, the purple shades and pink hues in there. They're more subtle. Pastel colors. You know, the determination to not replace the cracked panes, but rather to keep the broken panes and just sort of acknowledge that they are original cracked panes, that's a key consideration. And we spent some time hashing that out. Aside from that, the assembly was pretty technical and detailed, especially around the jewels. One of the things, when we clean these pieces, we have to make sure that we're putting them back exactly in the same place they came from, because though the cutting looks like everything is symmetrical and perfect and all, we find that they're just tiny little differences that'll shift the pieces, and they all have to relate to one another. So that takes time and care. Our work on that probably took about 4 days, I think. Yeah, more or less. Came out fine. Came out very nice. And it's good for 100 years, and I guarantee that. I'll give you a written guarantee on that.